I know I've spoken a lot about persistence and constancy and consistency and doing the same thing over and over and over and all that good stuff, but I came across a story recently that hopefully I will do justice to in rehearsing it to you, and that is what's called Fermat's Last Theorem. Fermat, I don't know how to pronounce that, he was a French lawyer, philosopher, mathematician in the 17th century, and came up with a theorem around, here's another theorem, the Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. You'll remember that from your middle school days. And his theorem was that there was no way that applied when the exponent, the squared, the 2, was anything other than 2. So a cubed plus b cubed can never equal c cubed. It just doesn't work. And his mathematical bent was to try and prove that. Spent his entire life doing that, and then in his books and records there was a margin note saying, I have finally proved the theorem. There's not enough room here to write it all. I'll write it later. And then he passed away a few days later. So for hundreds of years the theorem was supposedly solved or resolved, but no one knew how. And then along came, in the 1970s, a mathematician in England called Andrew Wiles. He's now one of my heroes. And ever since he was a young child, a bit of a mathematical bent, and came across this Fermat's Last Theorem, and said, I'm going to try and solve that thing. Went to Oxford, graduated as a doctorate in mathematics, and spent 8 full-time years trying to prove that theorem, that there was no resolution of any degree of numbers of a to the x plus b to the x equals c to the x. And then after 8 years of full-time work, and that's interesting how academics can spend 8 years full-time solving stuff that none of us really think about, but that's great. I'm wonderful there are people like that and have the opportunity to do that. He then solved it, published the results. Hallelujah, well done, I have resolved this centuries-old challenge. Good on me. And then about 6 months later, someone proved to him that his proof wasn't accurate. There was an error in it. And so what did Andrew Wiles do? Crawl into a corner and grab his knees and rock back and forth, get angry, be disappointed. I'm sure he went through a whole range of emotions because a life's work to that point was then undone. No, what he did was he went back to work. And over 8 months, they said he averaged about 20 to 22 hours a day over 8 months, sought to reprove the theorem such that in 8 months, 30 years ago, reproved the theorem and it has yet to be disproved. Forget the mathematics, forget the theorems and the Pythagorean theorem and Fermat and mathematics and squares and cubes and all the rest. Forget all that. Focus on the persistence. Here is a young guy that whose attention was caught by something that he had a passion for, went to work on it, made it his life's work, and then was given a kidney shot when what he thought was right and good and true turned out to not be. And rather than give up, went back to work again with a full-time, significant, overwhelming effort and finally gained the victory. Now, maybe it'll be disproved tomorrow. By the time you watch this video, it's already been disproved again. I don't think so. My guess is his second time around, he looked at it every which way and was able to prove Fermat's Last Theorem. Great example to me of perseverance. Perhaps that's where Wayne Gretzky got his famous saying of, you missed 100% of the shots you don't take. It's about staying at it, keeping at it. When those little obstacles along the way over the first 8 years, or the huge obstacle at the end, what he thought was the end, proved it wasn't there, he just stayed with it. Same thing with this business. You're going to have little obstacles along the way. You're going to have huge obstacles. You're going to have everything you want to happen maybe not happen, or not happen in the time frame you thought. Just stay with it. That power of persistence, the power of consistency and constancy and application over time, number one, makes you better. And number two, gets you there. So learn from Andrew Wiles, one of my new heroes. Google him. Google Andrew Wiles. Google Fermat's Last Theorem. Get a much better version of this story than I've been able to tell you, other than it's inspiring to me, the power of persistence and just staying at it and winning in the end, for you always do when in the end, in one way or another, when you just stick with it. Good luck.